Deep in the jungles of Brazil's Amazon rainforest lies the ruins of what appears to be a classic American suburb. This is Fordlandia, a town envisioned by Henry Ford, who founded the Ford Motor Company and popularized the automobile. It was his epitome of what a city should be, a perfect settlement that would be central to his business empire. But Fordlandia would ultimately fall apart. And today, the city he pumped more than $280 million into has faded into disrepair and ruin, an American ghost town hidden in the jungle. In 1903, Henry Ford, a businessman from the suburbs of Detroit, founded the Ford Motor Company. He would go on to invent the assembly line method, which would revolutionize business and enable him to easily mass produce automobiles for a cheap price, making them accessible and affordable for many people. Cars quickly became popular, but by 1928, Ford was facing some problems. Cars needed tires, which are made of rubber. Believe it or not, rubber came from trees, specifically the rubber tree, and is sort of like a sap. Ford got most of their rubber from Sri Lanka, where it was easily accessible. But in the late 1920s, Sri Lanka was a British colony, and Britain charged Ford high prices on purchasing rubber. Ford was tired of it. Wanting to bring down costs, he decided to harvest the sap and produce the tires himself. But it wouldn't be as easy as it sounded. By 1928, he was producing 15 million cars a year. Producing that much rubber would require a heavily staffed full-time operation, somewhere where rubber trees grew. But many regions with abundant supply of rubber trees were still colonies of European powers, with one notable exception, Brazil. On top of that, the Amazon was enormous, and would supply more than enough rubber for Ford's vehicles. The economy of Brazil, specifically of the Amazon, was suffering, and their government was eager to hash out a deal. In exchange for 9% of Ford's profits from producing tires, the Brazilian government gave him 3,900 square miles, or 10,000 square kilometers of land, sitting beside the Rio Tapajós, a tributary of the Amazon. There, Ford would build a town to house the rubber plant and its workers, and he wouldn't have to pay any taxes on exporting his tires out of Brazil. He called the town Fordlandia, and it would be designed to house 10,000 people. But this wouldn't just be any town. It would be an American town, designed around Ford's notions of American values. He constructed classic American houses throughout the town, an American-style swimming pool, school, hospital, playground, library, golf course, and hotel. The United States was in the midst of Prohibition, so Fordlandia didn't allow alcohol either. But that wasn't all. They banned smoking, playing soccer, or as it's known in much of the world, football. They even banned women from the town. On top of that, the Brazilian and American workers lived in different neighborhoods. The American village had all the modern amenities I talked about earlier, but the Brazilian neighborhood didn't even have running water. The parts of Fordlandia where the Brazilian workers lived were clearly much less invested in by the company than the parts where the Americans lived, and the Brazilians were getting mad. When tensions did boil over, it was about, interestingly enough, food. Part of Henry Ford's vision of spreading American values into the Amazon meant making the locals eat American food. American food doesn't exactly have the best reputation internationally. As an American myself, I feel a responsibility to let you know that there are plenty of delicious and unique regional and local foods across the United States that Henry Ford could have served, had he wanted to give the workers at Fordlandia a good view of American culture. Instead, he decided to force them to eat cheaply made burgers and canned food. The resentment over the food was really a representation of a much deeper anger over Ford's incredibly strict rules for those living in the town. It hit especially hard for the Brazilian workers, who had been given the worst end of the bargain, lacking basic amenities and being subject to incredibly stringent guidelines for conduct. Fordlandia had become a mini dictatorship, and in every dictatorship, there is a revolution. Fordlandia's was known as the Breaking Pans. The revolt began over the food they were forced to eat. Disgruntled Brazilian workers cut the telegraph wires that connected the isolated town to the outside world, and for days chased the town cook and the Ford executives managing the settlement deep into the jungle. Eventually, the Brazilian army had to be called in to quell the revolt, and locals negotiated with the company to get better food. but the Breaking Pans was just one symptom of a town that was doomed from the start. While the Brazilians were subject to strict rules and terrible living conditions, the Americans faced a whole new problem of their own. They were living in the Amazon, and diseases like malaria and yellow fever ran wild through the town. Besides that, no roads actually connected it to anything else, and it could only be accessed by boat. Despite Henry Ford's attempt to make it just like any town in the United States, Fordlandia was isolated and difficult to live in. The classic American small town simply couldn't survive in the middle of the Amazon. On top of that, Ford had no experience in growing and harvesting rubber, and planting the trees too close together, they were decimated by pests. In 1934, they tried to move to another town, which they called Belterra, but it didn't last long. The final nail in the coffin for Ford's attempt to build an American town in the Amazon was the creation of synthetic rubber, which by its invention in 1945 completely removed the need for rubber trees, making the existence of both towns suddenly useless. That year, the company sold Fordlandia and Belterra back to Brazil, having lost what is today $284 million by creating them. For over half a century a ghost town, Fordlandia is seeing a rebirth, with its population climbing from just 90 to around 3,000 in the last few years, as people begin to move back into the ruins of the American-style homes deep in the Amazon rainforest that stand as a reminder of one businessman's failed utopia. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you learned something new. Subscribe for more content like this. I cover the countries, cities, people, and places of the world and beyond. These videos will leave you saying, "That is interesting."